All right, so today I wanted to talk a little bit about motivation and when you've sort of lost your momentum with eating healthy, working out, feeling good. Look, there's no, I have worked out my entire life, but there are times when I hit a wall and it sucks, right? I mean, it's like, there's nothing I can do. I just finished just recently a 3-week run of barely even being able to do anything in the gym. It was terrible. I mean, completely demoralizing. And not that working out is the most important thing in the world, but it's a gateway for me. It makes me feel really good. It makes me feel energetic. It makes me feel like I, you know, just can take care of things. It makes me feel good to be in my body. I love it. And, no matter how much I've worked out and no matter how easy it might seem for me, to think that when I think of others who have come to me and I work with them and they're out of shape and, you know, their diet is, really bad, and the answers are so simple, right? But it's not about the answers so much. It's about what's our motivation, how are we feeling, how are we handling, you know, stress, how are we handling fatigue, how are we reacting to things. And so really that's a big part of when I work with people is helping coach them through sort of these inherent limitations of human condition where we can't seem to think outside of our present where we're at. You know, our hormones are changing constantly, especially women. Our sleep affects us, our stress affects us, our lifestyle affects us. And so those challenges and stresses in life tend to perpetuate poor decisions. And when you get on a roll and you get some momentum, it's so easy to work out. It's so easy to eat right. It's so easy to supplement. It's so easy to go to bed on time when your circadian rhythm is dialed in and it's 10 o'clock at night and you just get tired, you go to sleep. You know, when you get on a roll with this stuff, it's so easy. But having had this 3-week run where I didn't even know if I was sick, I didn't know what was going on, it really humbled me. It made me realize, hey, you know, I have to do the things that I advise others to do. I have to take these baby steps. I have to realize that I'm not going to be able to do some massive workout and get a huge pump and feel amazing and go to that degree where I'm at like absolute failure and just push through there and just feel, you know, or do some high intensity workout where I just feel amazing afterwards. I wasn't gonna be able to do that. I had to do a simple workout. I had to just show up. I had to actually just go to the gym. Maybe it was just stretching. Maybe it was just doing some light cardio and then turned into maybe a weight workout where I couldn't even get one decent set in, right? But those baby steps allowed me to start to work through this, to keep my habit, because I went almost 2 weeks without working out and it was like, oh my God, I've totally fallen off my rhythm here. I am completely not wanting to work out. I don't think about working out. I don't make it a priority. I don't schedule it. And so when we're getting back into it, we have to baby step our way back into it. And the most important thing is to build that momentum, because once we have some momentum where we're like, ah, this is working, then we feel like we're in control again, that we can create a desired effect, right? It's like when I work with weight loss clients, at first it's like, you know, they don't believe. They don't necessarily believe it's gonna work. And then once they are patient, baby step it, keep adding to that, keep refining, keep just building those habits so it becomes second nature, stacking more habits on top of that. All of a sudden it's like, they see the results. The results will always come. And then you get that momentum where you feel empowered. And then boom, you're back on the upswing again. And then it becomes easy to maintain that and go further down the rabbit hole in terms of your sophistication, in terms of stacking more habits. But this whole video was to basically kind of be humble enough to say, if you have fallen off your game, if your body is somewhat becoming a holding prison cell for you because you feel like you don't have the energy to power through things, your diet is terrible, you can't even think about going to the gym, I understand. I totally understand. As an Olympic athlete, I still go through the same thing. I've worked out my entire life. I promise you, we're all human. We all feel the same thing. So when you're feeling like, oh, I can't get anything done, just baby step it. I know it sounds rather cliche, but anything will help. And anything to move yourself towards a desired outcome will get easier and easier if you continue to do it, because it becomes habit, it becomes automatic. We don't think about brushing our teeth all the time, right? It's not a debate anymore whether or not we're gonna brush our teeth. I gotta brush my teeth. No, you just do it. You just do it because you don't want cavities, you don't want gum disease, you don't want to give someone to take out a tooth, you know? You just, you inherently, you know the benefit of brushing your teeth and you don't have to negotiate that anymore. And that's where we wanna try to get with eating well, and we wanna get there with exercise. And then from there you can branch out, and also you know being aware of how a certain, when we've started to fall off our game and maybe you haven't slept well in a while, if you haven't slept well, you're going to be craving different foods, you're going to be wanting quick energy. If you are stressed, you're going to be wanting quick energy, and you're probably going to be eating crappy food, you know, probably more processed food, probably more sugary food, more caffeine, and you're going to start to baby step out of your momentum, right? So it's death by a thousand paper cuts, right? It's like, I don't really notice it, don't really notice it, don't really notice it. But by the time you've gotten the thousandth paper cut, you know, you have a wound, you know, that it can no longer just be thought of as a paper cut, right? That's life-changing. So that's it. If you have any comments, if you like this type of material, I like talking about, I feel like I'm sort of, I don't know. I think about this stuff, and sometimes I'm just like, why don't I share it, you know, because I'm so tired of just posting pictures or videos or something on Instagram where it's like, look how much healthy and great I am, and look at what meals I eat that are so conscious, and look at this, you know, workout thing that I do, or this new health gadget. And it's like, that's great, and maybe that's empowering, but I think sometimes, you know, you need to see that, man, sometimes life just fucking beats you down a little bit. Excuse my language, but it does. And sometimes you get in a rut, you know, and that's okay. It's gonna happen to the best of us. I can assure you of that. And when you're down like that, you need someone to maybe talk truthfully to you from a place of like, hey, I know what it's like. I've been there, you know, and you can get out of it. You can baby step your way back in, start to build some habits, gain some momentum, and then you're back in the game. So that's it. That's all I'm going to talk about right now. Thanks for listening.